Good morning, NBFL fans. Again, abbreviated version because I just don't have a lot of time, but I want to get something out here. The Ecuador and Galapagos trip went really well, and so well that I remain hot, beating Pacaguamo 117-102. The poor Pups would have beaten almost every other team in the league with 102, but not the Creek, who remains hot with Lamar Jackson and Eddie McCaffrey's son. Boy, Christian, even though the Packers aren't by, Creek rolls. In our other game, Rainforest taking on hapless Maple Creek. The Beavers hosting the Frogs, and they just got another shellacking as Raining Tree goes an 85-71 win over Hammers Beef. Raining Tree goes to 5-6, so the Beavers follow 2-9, and looking like they'll be playing for a third place game with four games to go. The Frogs, still scoring a lot of points. Hoskin keeps their brief hopes alive by taking down the hapless Scallywags, 105-90. Despite putting up a lot of points, they're four games behind Doherty Creek, but the tiebreaker is prohibitive, so they will have to win out and then beat Doherty Creek on an average of 53 points a game per week to somehow get in the gold bowl. Meanwhile, everybody's pulling for Curtis to remain in last place and lose a toilet bowl, because then we can save money on buying a new I Shave My Balls for This t-shirt. Shawnee needed a win to stay with his bro, but scoring 49 points, you ain't gonna do shit. Sorry, your mom, Sean, I wouldn't even invite you over for Thanksgiving with 49 points. Holy crap, that's bad. The Brookies, though, big win for them. With Pacaguamo losing, the Brookies move into a tie for first place into the East. Very much alive, trying to get a tournament where, of course, anything can happen in weeks 16 and 17. This was one of the best games of the year. Apple River needed 5 more yards rushing to beat Smiley's Hares, because it couldn't do it. Smiley hangs on 67.16. Seriously, that's 4 yards rushing. That's how tight this game was. Billy's needed that. That means that the horseshoe is running away. Horseshoe, once again, looking like they have the inside track to get into the tournament to be first place. Sand Lake takes down the former champs. French Creek falls, and they will fall into third place. Sand Creek 96 points, French Creek 64. Sand Creek looking like they are a lock for first place into the Rose Bowl tournament. Harvesters go 5-6, staying in third place in the West. Meanwhile, the aforementioned Horseshoe Bucks once again making a run at another title, which they would be their third. They can get into the tournament and win 2 games. They take down Eagle Point 80-73 in a good game. Eagle Point now playing for a second or third place game, apparently, in the Northern Division. Horseshoe has a commanding lead over Apple River, and looking like they can, unless they lay an egg, there's some like buck turd or something like that, should be in pretty good shape to get into the tournament. In a battle between a couple of last place teams, Otter Bay takes down Upper Turtle 80-77. Otter Bay keeping their hopes alive to move up into a possible second place game. Upper Turtle still in it too, but they need to start winning some games rather than laying some monkey eggs. The Twins go to 4-7, as do the Monkeys, but both teams, as I said, could try to get out of that fourth place tournament by winning a few games. Okay, it's time to look at the standings portion of our little show here. Again, starting with the East. The Pacaguamas loss, the 4 Miles win. We have the one race in the league that's actually knotted up and competitive. Pacaguamo, they fall to 7-4. 4 Mile right on the heels. Pacaguamo having a 54-point lead in the tiebreaker. East River has to win out to try to get into a third place game. Raining Tree still an outside shot. We gotta run the table and then get a lot of help with one interleague game to play. North Division, like the rest of the divisions, looks like it's all done. As far as the first place game goes, Bulls with Sand Lake Sharks winning handily again. They're on a roll. They're on a streak. no way that they'll get caught at this point. They have a 3-game lead over Rabbit Trail, so mathematically it's still possible. Over 200 points in the tiebreaker. Outer Bay is actually in good shape for moving up into a possible third or even second place game because of their tiebreaker situation. +417 in the morning, boys. Apologize for any incoherency. I sound like I'm drunk, but I'm just tired. Anyway, South Division. Doherty Creek is just rolling. It's a better dream year for the people living on the hill, which is like three dogs myself. And so we go to 9-2, 284 point lead in the tiebreaker of Apaskan. All done, pretty much. South Doherty and Apaskan will be fun to watch it out. They'll, Carboys will probably get the fight like in the barn like they did over this. And then, so it really won't matter who will win, just who will win this little barn fight that they'll have. Anyway, in the West Division, Apple River really needed to beat Horseshoe. They really needed that win, Rabbit Trail. And with that loss, they slid further behind in the standings. Going now to 6-5, that's 3 games back with 4 games to play. Again, they'll need a lot of help. The tiebreaker keeps it mathematically possible. Apple River, French Creek, and Upper Turtle all competing for even a possible second place game, so still a lot to play for as 1 game left to go in the interleague balance. Now, remember, we get money for that. So, it's tightened up. The West has the best record still, 24-20. The North is just 1 game back, and with the West and the North playing each other, the West can win $25 per player if they go 2-2. Whereas the North can go 3-1, they can split it, making it a $12.50 for 8 people. And the North can sweep it, actually, and then take all $25 away from the West. Okay, time to look at our standings. I also have added another column. Oh, French Creek didn't get theirs updated. But anyway, another column on the right that shows how many points you are off your division leader. How many points that you are off overall under the back category. And then under, again, division leader, how far back from the team that's leading your division. So, Maple Grove, doesn't matter how you do this, man, they're sucking ass. Almost 452 points back. I'm moving up the chain. I would put French Creek at 415 back. South Doherty, Eagle Point, East River, actually not finishing last in scoring right now, which would be cause for raucous celebration. Now looking at the top, first 5 spots pay off. Doherty Creek running away, 169 point lead over Sand Lake, over 200 on all the rest of you boys. Remember, you want to hang in there because there is money involved. You can see division leaders hit pause if you need to do that. I'm going to take another drink of some stale Diet Coke here as we finish up our little NBFL Week 11 show. It's a good time to review our constitution, as again we're going just 1 week away from interleague play. You can see the championship numbers there for winning that. You can hit pause at any time, of course, because you all know how to work your fucking smartphones. And there, the second place and third place tournaments are listed right there. And then here we go with, if you finish in the fourth place, what can happen to you? I need your t-shirt size somebody. Again, if it's Kurt, we already got it. And then there's our points winners listed out right there, which comes up. And this is, again, not a presentation of the Northern Badger Football League. And everybody have a good week. And again, sorry for the uncreative lack of video that I have, but it's just going to be this way as I am behind on everything. So I'll talk to you all later.